Welcome to cat.com.
What's good is A.P. One in a billion and I'm back.
About to get an elbow in the head. It's your favorite diva, Dangerous Diva.
Oh, to the yeah.
And we're back. Back like we never left.
Oh yeah, where my... No, I was...
We're wearing gold. We're very, very festive today. You want to know why?
U.S. team is getting it in.
We're kicking butt.
You know what I mean?
Winning gold medals and stuff.
Left and right. I can't front China. Y'all doing y'all thing.
Yeah.
Ni hao. You know what I mean? Ni hao to my peoples out there.
You know? You guys are doing your thing. But you know, U.S., we're...
U.S. is...
Team is holding us down.
It. Swimming. We killing the swimming.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
The gymnastics.
Ooh! The gymnastics. Let's go right into that.
Yes.
With the young girl, Gabby Douglas.
She is just such a cutie pie.
You see her?
This cute little petite thing.
She got that big smile. Remind me of your smile.
I know.
That
so
big smile.
Cute.
Exactly. Y'all know it's no excuse. But anyway.
Besides that, I mean, if you Google Gabby's name, you know what's gonna come up?
What's coming up right now?
Gabby Douglas Hair.
Wow.
How is her hair more important? This isn't a model competition, right?
No.
This is an athletic competition.
Exactly.
And half the people that were saying stuff were not athletic at all.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just the obsession with her hair has gotten outrageous. She was trending on Twitter.
First off, listen. She's black. She's an African American. Be proud of having African-American
hair.
You know what I mean? Like, especially for a guy to say something about that. Don't you have... That's like talking about your sister, talking about your mother.
Your mother?
Talking about your great-grandmother, talking about all of your ancestors.
And why, like, why is that even the issue? They were talking about, oh, she has too much gel in her hair. She needs to fix the BDBs in her hair. Look at her hair. It's so tacky.
Listen.
This is black people tearing each other down. Why is it when we do anything or we try to succeed at anything, the others don't even tear us down? It's our own race.
Exactly.
That is the first to say anything. Whether it's her skin color or her hair or she thinks she's hot, she thinks she got it on, got it going on. Oh, she thinks she can sing. I look better than her. Why is it always competition or putting somebody else down?
Listen, I got a segment later on and what it's called is niggas versus blacks. Alright. So let's correct ourselves. We just don't want to say nigga. Okay?
But I mean,
really,
it's really,
when we say black people tearing each other up, no. Niggas tearing down black people. That's what's going on. So for those of you that are of a different race and you don't understand us, because we understand each other.
Right.
There's niggas and there's black people. Mm-hmm. So check out this video right here, alright? You'll learn the difference. And you'll learn, even if you are black or a nigga, you're gonna find out which category you fall in. If you're black or you're a nigga.
I can give you countless times that this has come up. Michelle Obama, the first black first lady of America. She gets talked about for, oh, she needs to press her hair. Look at her edges. Oh, this, oh, that.
For real?
Yes.
I don't know if you know about that.
It's like a threat because black women's hair is not naturally straight. It's naturally curly. Honestly, different textures of naturally curly. Curly hair is like wild. And then straight hair, which most Caucasian people have, is considered polished and pretty. So it's more threatening. Like, you can't get a corporate job and have natural hair or just come, you know. You don't understand the different things that we go through.
What made, who,
as a culture.
Who said that was pretty? When did that, who says that that's pretty?
That is the, that's what's in media, period. On magazines, that's in corporate America. You can't come in, I can't wear my hair all natural coming in and work. They're gonna look at you like, Siobhan, you need to go back. You need to go back home and, you know, fix your hair. You can't come in there with like no afro.
Why?
If I wanted to wear wild or curly and just, you know, no, that's not polished.
Why is that such a threat? I don't get it. Why do you have to look like the next person? Why can't you just be your own individual? I don't get that.
I don't understand how a hair can make you lesser or more of a person. I really don't.
Exactly.
You tell me what you think the problem is. But besides that, Beyonce even got lashed out for her daughter. She's 6 months old.
Mm.
And the black little girls and boys, the black people went in on her.
No, calling, they didn't. The niggas did.
Yeah. Went in on her 6 months. And you guys wonder why she keeps her covered up. You wonder why she keeps her covered up. Because people were calling her all kinds of ugly, and she looks so ugly, and I wish she looked, she got her daddy's look and her nappy hair. And how can you talk like that about your own people? A 6 month old baby.
Y'all ain't my people. Y'all niggas, all right? The people that talk like that, they're niggas.
And
you're not black.
You have a deep rooted issue. You need to get that taken care of. You don't know where that stemmed from. Find out, because it's self-hatred.
Your Uncle Tom, right? That's what y'all, a bunch of Uncle Toms. Y'all need to study the Willie Lynch syndrome, because that's just what y'all got. You know what I mean? Y'all like crabs in a barrel. Y'all still fighting against your own people. Like, that doesn't even make sense to me.
It really doesn't.
Like, if anything, you know what I mean? Like, we don't wrestle against flesh and blood. You know what I mean? We wrestle against the principality. You know what I mean? So, if you ever hear me critical or somebody, it's more of a spiritual thing, more spiritual warfare. You doing something demonic or something right. like that. I have more to say than just on physical. You know what I mean? So, people need to get that together. Realize
we
who you are.
We need to come together as a whole. Black people, stop tearing down black people. You We're killing I mean? Each other. We're talking about each other, tearing each other down. We go through enough in this world already. We don't need the extra stuff.
Little Gabby has been getting it handed to her by all these announcers, all of this.
Yes.
And then after all of that, her old teammates barely even wanted to hug her or talk to her or anything. They hating on her. And then she wins the whole thing. She one of the youngest people there, the slimmest one out of everybody, wins the whole thing. Young black girl coming from the struggle. And what? That's how you reward her with tweets that saying negative stuff about her hair? You should be ashamed of yourself, man.
Ridiculous.
You should be ashamed of yourself. Listen, she's the first ever African-American woman to win this award. This is an unbelievable achievement.
It's going down in history.
You know what I mean? So she's
she
about
just
to
made
get,
history.
She's about to get all types of endorsements, all types of everything.
Yeah,
I even saw like one of the clips they showed her with her hair down. It looked nice. She looked, her hair looked real good. So she's about to get all kind of deals right now.
Good for you, Gabby. I mean, when you're competing, your main thing is you don't want your hair getting in the way. If you looked at it, all the girls had their hair pulled back. What did they expect her to get her hair pressed working out?
And listen.
Come on.
This is what y'all don't understand. The advantage that we have in sports is the fact that because our hair is naturally curly, it's not moving all over the place.
Exactly.
So we're able to do a whole lot more. You know what I mean? So look into that. Maybe you might want to curl your hair up too. Shout out to Gabby. We're proud of you.
Congratulations.
Hey, we'd love to do an interview with you. We're Welcome to Cali TV.
Definitely.
Or Welcome to NYC TV.